Welcome to Melbourne. You can hear the roar of the crowd out there, which can only mean one thing. Race day is upon us. We're a stone's throw from the enormous Port Phillip Bay for today's race at the 3.3-mile Albert Park Circuit. It's a bumpy racing surface here, and the 16 corners could prove especially difficult in the wet conditions. Watch out for a safety car at some point during the Grand Prix. Joining me on this very wet day is a man who's no stranger to driving in miserable conditions. Anthony Davidson, you've driven open cockpit, you've driven sports cars. How does the wet weather experience change between the different disciplines?
Well, I wouldn't say there's much difference in all honesty. You know, besides the terrifying closing speeds you find in sports cars with the different categories all sharing the same track, driving in the rain is, well, driving in the rain. Of course, the biggest difference between the two is the closed cockpit versus the open cockpit. You get the luxury of staying dry in the sports car, but if your screen ever gets dirty, well, that's a pit stop, not just wiping your visor or pulling away a tear off. But most of the time, you know, they're both as miserable as each other, to be honest.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Daniel Ricciardo has a clear view ahead from pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Bottas, Charles Leclerc and Perez, the owner driver, Sainz, Coulthard, they've taken a grid penalty, and Lance Stroll, Ocon, Gasly, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Russell, Norris, Schwartzman, Mick Schumacher, and Nicholas Latifi, Fernando Alonso, Tsunoda, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, Tictum, and Nikita Mazepin. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
Well, they played the safety car to absolute perfection. There are so many factors to worry about once the race is neutralized. I mean, do you pit for fresh rubber? Do you have the space behind you? How much fuel can you save? If you answer all of those questions correctly, you'll have a good chance. And that's exactly what happened today.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. That lead at the top of the table has shrunk somewhat today. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Fernando Alonso. Wherever he is, whatever team he's in, when is he not just brilliant? He'll give you a performance every time, just like he's done today.
With that result, the sport's newest team can no longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many had written off a short time ago. They are Formula One World Champions. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.
We need your input on how to address an issue concerning our driver. Thanks. I appreciate you taking the time to help out. Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.